So what saws do you ultimately need for woodworking? Well, that's really going to depend on you, how much work you want to do by hand, and what other tools or machines you already have. Assuming you have nothing at all, you're going to need a saw to cross-cut rough lumber, you're going to need a saw to rip rough lumber, and you're going to need a saw that you can cross-cut and rip your joinery with. While you can maybe use larger saws to cut some of your joinery, for finer joinery, larger saws are simply going to be too aggressive and too coarse, and they're not going to make a fine enough cut. Similarly, smaller saws really are not going to be used to efficiently break down rough lumber, and saws with a back are not going to be able to make long rip cuts. They're simply not designed for that. These six saws are really the only saws that you would have to need for an entire lifetime of working by hand. There's a rip saw for breaking down rough lumber. There's a crosscut saw for breaking down rough lumber. There's a rip saw for joinery and a crosscut saw for joinery. You could argue that this saw could be used to cut dovetails, and it certainly could, but a lot of people will find that a smaller saw that is sized specifically for small detail work like dovetails is a little bit more user-friendly than trying to cut small dovetails in a drawer side with a larger rip saw like this, which is designed more for large tenon cheeks for things like table aprons. The only other saw you would then need is something to cut curves, and that's where the bow saw comes in. This saw can cut just about any curve you need it to cut. Now, let's say you don't want to go and invest in all six of these saws, and you certainly are not going to need all six of these saws for what we're going to do in this course. But if you maybe have, let's say, a bandsaw or a circular saw or a jigsaw that you can use to rip your lumber, if you've got a circular saw or a jigsaw, you can even use that for rough cross-cutting, you could potentially eliminate one or both of these large saws. If you're using a bandsaw for ripping, you could also use that bandsaw for cutting curves, and you would be able to potentially eliminate this saw here. That leaves your joinery saws. Now, you could just use a 14-inch joinery saw such as this one, file it or sharpen it in such a way that it will cross-cut and rip respectively. And there are geometries that you can file that will do that. It won't be the most efficient cross-cutting saw, and it won't be the most efficient rip-cutting saw, but it can be used to do the job of both if filed in a certain way. So you could use a saw like this here, this 14-inch saw, for dovetailing, cross-cutting tenon shoulders, sawing tenon cheeks, and that's really just about all of the joinery needs that you have to worry about. So you could make do with a single saw, but having several different options for several different situations does give you a little bit more freedom, and efficiency is really what it generates by having multiple saws. But these six saws are really all the saws I've needed to do all the work that I've done by hand for over 20 years. So really, if you got yourself a nest of six saws like this, there's nothing you couldn't do with handsaws.